Well, good morning once again from the Ministry of Musselburgh Congregational Church. It's lovely to be with you. And in the background, we have Westlife playing You Raise Me Up to More Than I Can Be. And I know from personal experience, this is so true. When we yield our lives to God, my goodness, in His hands, what is possible for us to become is beyond our imagining. Life is like a great ocean flowing this way and that. Sometimes it's still and calm, but at other times it's turbulent and stormy. And people join us in our journey. Some people remain for a lifetime, those we most deeply love. But others drift in like something in the tide and then drift out again, hardly noticed. But even if they have touched the sands of our lives momentarily, they leave an impression, as we must do, on them. God uses our life experiences to teach us many things, and often it's through our most difficult trials that He brings the greatest growth in our character and makes us more able to cope with whatever may come along. Think of a ship's captain at sea. When the waters are calm and still, he's not challenged in any way. He's simply doing what he's always done. It's when the squalls come along, the storms come along, suddenly he's at his sharpest, his most astute, most alert, and pulling together all his skills and past experiences as he struggles to get through. But through it all, he'll be better equipped to deal with the next storm that will undoubtedly come along. In chapter 5 of Romans, Paul writes, "Suffering produces perseverance, perseverance, character, and character, hope." The storms of our lives can leave us feeling quite broken, but to my own experience, God brings beauty from brokenness. Not only does God see us as we are, but He knows all that it's possible for us to become, and He longs for us to be all that we can be, the very best version of ourselves. I travelled to Durham in December and visited Durham Cathedral, and if you've ever been there, you know that there are giant size carvings of Christ and His mother, and they are simply breathtaking. When these trees were felled, it wasn't the end of their lives, it was the beginning of something new, a new chapter. For many months they must have been chipped away at, honed, shaped and planed, until eventually they became what they are now, articles of great beauty that move people to contemplate on the agony of Jesus and the heartbreak of His mother Mary. Who would have thought that these trees, magnificent as they were, could become something even greater? God chooses to work in the world through His people. We are the work of His hands. And by yielding to Him, He may use us as instruments for the purpose of His kingdom. In His wisdom, God allows life to shape and hone us, to sharpen us or soften us, to bless us with wisdom and understanding of many experiences of life. For it's coming through our own trials that we are then clothed in understanding and compassion, equipped to comfort and tend the wounds of others. Only then can we truly live out God's greatest commandment to love one another. Before Jesus left this earth, He gave us this promise. And remember, His promises will never fail us. I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. I am with you always, even till the end of time. Come unto me, all those who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Whatever you are going through just now, God is in it with you, calling you to fix your eyes upon Jesus. Look full on His wonderful face, for only then the things of this earth grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and his grace. May God raise you up to more than you can be. Trust him. Amen.